So we have in Christ a glorious high priest. He's passed into heaven for me to make intercession for me. But he is a sympathetic high priest because he understands my weakness, because he became a man and he experienced the temptations that man experiences. He knows my problems. He knows my weaknesses. And thus he can empathize with me. Oh, what a glorious high priest that we have. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace. How can I ever come boldly to the throne of grace except through Jesus Christ? Dare you come boldly to the throne of grace asking God to accept your works or to reward you for what you've done now? Lord, look what I've done for you this week. Now I'd like to receive my rewards today. No, I'll tell you, I can only come to God through Jesus Christ. I don't dare come to God on my own. But through Him I come boldly. Because my great high priest understands my weaknesses. He was tempted just like I am. That's why He is able to help me in my time of temptation. And so I come boldly to the throne of grace, not to the justice bar of God to receive the works rewards. I don't come to the paymaster to get my pay for the work I've done, but I come to the throne of grace that I might obtain mercy and find grace to help me in my time of need. And so I approach God on the basis of His grace and mercy towards me, not on the basis of my works and my deserving. And because I approach God on the basis of His goodness and His grace towards me, I can come boldly and I can always receive the help that I need. I can find grace to help me in the time of my need. Because I'm coming on the basis of God's invitation to me as His child. Now, in our minds, because we hold in our minds this concept of rewards for goodness and for good works that we carry from childhood, if you're good today, you can have ice cream for dessert tonight. And so instilled in me from a child is this reward for goodness and punishment for badness. No ice cream for you tonight. You've been bad today. You know, and even Santa Claus makes out a list and checks it twice. And you're going to get a bundle of sticks because you've been naughty. And so it's hard for us to think in the terms of grace. But it's important that we come to God by virtue of His grace, not by virtue of our merit or our goodness or our works. Because if I come by virtue of my goodness, then most of the time I can't come. If I come by the virtue of God's grace, I can come any time. If I come on the virtue of my deserving, then I'll get very little because I don't deserve very much. But if I come on the basis of His grace, then hey, it's wide open. Everything, anything I might need, it's there. Richly, freely bestowed upon me because God loves me and He is a merciful, gracious, loving, compassionate God who knows my needs and my weaknesses and sympathizes and empathizes with me and for me. It's So how are you going to approach God? On the basis of your goodness, your efforts, your work? Or on the basis of the finished work of Jesus Christ? So, here I am, resting tonight. Because I'm not resting in myself, in my righteousness, but I'm resting in His finished work for me. Here I come tonight, God. Not on the basis of I've had a good week and everything's been flowing well. But I'm coming on the basis that You love me and You've invited me to come to receive of Your grace through Jesus. And I just believe You, Lord, to help me, though I don't deserve it. To bless me, though I'm really not worthy of it. But just because You are a God of love and a God who is so gracious and merciful, Lord, bless me now. And I believe and trust God to bless me. And so He does. Because the blessings are always predicated upon the faith and believing Him to do so. The lack of blessing does not come from the lack of your devotions, but your lack of faith. Now that's hard for us to grasp, isn't it? Oh, I haven't, been faithful in my devotions this week. I really shouldn't ask God to help me. I really failed Him again. No, I know there's no use asking Him because I know He won't help me because, boy, I just did such a miserable thing this week, And I just know that. I just dare not ask Him for anything. I know He won't do it, man. I just know. And you know what? He won't. If you have that attitude. If you don't believe Him to. See, the lack of blessing, though, isn't the lack of devotions. It's the lack of faith. Believing God to do it. Now, many times my failures get in the way of my faith because I am looking to my works rather than to His finished work. But if God can help us to grasp this concept, then your life is going to rest. And God is going to bless you. And as the result of those blessings of God, you're going to be responding to God in continual praise and thanksgiving and awe and wonder at all that God has done for you. He is so great and so merciful and so marvelous that you're just going to be constantly rejoicing and praising Him. Oh God, You're so good. I love You. You're so marvelous to me. And God will continue to bless and bless and bless and bring you into that rest that He has for His people. God help us tonight, we pray, to believe Your word and to trust in Your word and to believe in the finished work of Jesus Christ, our great High Priest, who has made the way for us to come boldly to the throne of grace, to receive the mercy and grace in our times of need. Oh Lord, how thankful we are for Your grace towards us and Your goodness and Your mercy that endures forever. How thankful we are for Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, our great High Priest, who has finished the work of our redemption so that we rest in His finished work. Lord, I'm saved because I believe in Jesus as my Savior. And because I am saved, I surrender my life to You as my Lord, that I might obey Thee and do whatever You want me to do that I might be a servant that is pleasing in the eyes of his master, because I love you, Lord, because you first loved me. Amen. Now may the Lord be with you to bless you this week, to pour out upon your life the riches of His love and His grace and His mercy towards you through Christ Jesus our Lord. And may you abound and be rich in all things in Christ.